We're learning more tonight about an incident in Cheektowaga where three young girls were burned while trying to toast marshmallows, leaving one of them critically hurt.
Channel 2's Dave McKinley showed us what happened, how the girls are doing, and how the community is stepping up to help.
It was last Thursday evening when the call came in to the Southline Fire Department. Chief Andrew Dayton tells us when firefighters arrived to a home on Jeffrey Drive, they found three young girls laying in the yard who'd been burned. At that home, along with their mother, live four sisters. Seen in this photo left to right, they are 7-year-old Madison, 9-year-old twins Cadence and Kennedy, and 4-year-old Aria Chinyeski. A source says the girls were gathered around a small tabletop fire pit, which uses rubbing alcohol as a fuel. Their uncle is Richard Stark.
They were trying to make s'mores, and the fire, there was a tragic accident explosion, and the accelerant, the fuel, sprayed out and landed on the girls.
9-year-old Cadence took the worst of it.
It's going to be a long road to recovery. She suffered severe burns.
So severe that she was medevaced to the Kessler Pediatric Burn Treatment Center at Golisano Children's Hospital at Strong Memorial in Rochester.
It's a day-to-day situation. She's stabilized from the initial, I would say, trauma, which was very serious when it had happened, and they're looking for next steps in terms of multiple. There's going to be a lot of skin graft operations, and she suffered large area of burns.
In the meantime, a GoFundMe page has been established, which already has raised more than $47,000 to help with expenses so the girl's mother can stay with Cadence.
She's at the bedside in Rochester, and here we're caring for her three girls, and we're planning on taking them out to visit them this week.
Stark says the family is overwhelmed and grateful for the generosity being shown by others. As their investigation continues, Cheektowaga police say the girl's mother was present during this incident, which again occurred while they were toasting marshmallows. And at this point, they say there is nothing to suggest that this was anything other than a tragic accident. Dave McKinley, Channel 2 News.